Hey, what's up, garden friends?
Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party. How's everybody doing?
I hope you're good. I am great.
And remembering to turn the fan off at the beginning of the video, maybe. I mean, if it will, what the heck?
Better late than never, right?
Actually, I don't remember till I'm like 10 minutes into filming. Terrarium Tuesday. Never mind the batteries, I need to do something with those. We got some terrarium plants lined up here and a special terrarium that I want to do. I've been wanting to do for a while, actually.
Got a whole bunch of little plants here ready to be put into a terrarium.
I have one that I've been wanting to do for a while, a pretty long time, actually.
Isn't it pretty? Look at that.
So this is one of those molten glass style bowls. I got this one years ago. It was either at, I don't know if it was Garden Ridge or if it was At Home, because the two companies At Home bought out Garden. Regardless, I got a really good deal on it, and I haven't been able to find them for an affordable price since. So it's one of those things where I've kind of had it sitting around and just never really done anything extreme with it, because I actually really do enjoy just how it looks. Just looking at it with the glass over the wood, I think it just looks pretty. And I'm indecisive and overthink things sometimes. I have other ones of these that I've done in videos, and I may have planted this up with something many years ago on this channel. I don't remember if it was this one or a different one. I know I did one with succulents that I still have, and the succulents are still in it. That was probably 3 years ago. To me, this was the type of terrarium that really lends itself to doing something aquatic. I had thought about really just putting some water in here with maybe some Anubias and some sort of Microsorums, and keeping it just aquatic plants and keeping the entire thing submerged, just having water in there with a very small gravel bed with some charcoal in the bottom, aquarium carbon. Those are actually kind of high maintenance, really. I have really hard water, so I would have to constantly refill it with filtered water, or else there'd be rings at the top. And if you don't have a bunch of detritivores in there, like snails and some other things to help keep some of the debris cleaned up, then the water gets really funky. I don't know, it just isn't really something I feel like messing with. I've done it with some other things, but with this one, I was like, no, let's go plants. And I have plenty of plants here, and I figure that there's enough here that I can do something that will still give off kind of the appeal, the feel of water, but without it actually having to have water in it. That's the goal anyways. I don't know, we'll find out together. I have a soil blend here that's fairly well moistened up. I don't know how you're going to be able to tell that it's moistened up, but I could maybe wet it up a little bit more. I don't think I need to, though. This is a blend of Repti Soil, because that's what I've been using in a lot of my terrariums, and some Coco Bop, which is just a coconut-based potting mix that I've been using a lot just because I have a bag laying around. It's already opened. But it has a good blend of the coconut in here, some compost mix. I put some orchid bark in there, and I had added some sand to it, and it is very heavy in perlite because the Coco Bop is, there's a lot of perlite in there. I mixed the two together. It's probably three parts of the coconut plus organic garden compost potting mix. That's what the Coco Bop is. And then one part Repti Soil. I did that just because the Repti Soil holds on to moisture a little bit better. I've noticed that this Coco Bop, it dries out fairly quickly. It's very loamy, which is great, but not necessarily what I want for a terrarium where I want to make sure that there's some moisture in there. So my overall plan with this is going to be that I want to have just a small layer. Oh, I already messed up. Hold on, back up. Sometimes start talking to the camera and just get a little bit wonky in the head. My bad. I need to put something down on the bottom. So this isn't going to be a bioactive. I don't think there's anywhere near enough of a base in here to do something like that. I don't want the soil level to be very high at all. Essentially where this slope comes down right here and meets, that's where I want the top of the soil to be. So you can see there's not much there to work with, right? That's because I do still want to be able to kind of see through this gap that's in here. There's a, you can see the gap? The gap. I want to be able to see through that, because I think that adds a little bit of extra dimension, and it will just look nice. So because I don't have room to do like the proper layers to make this a true bioactive setup, I have this jar here where I've just kind of been throwing my leftover scraps from when I just have like a little bit of pumice and a little bit of charcoal left, and I'm going to just put a little bit of that in there in the very bottom. Not very much at all down there, just enough so that there's a little spot for some water to collect. There's the carbon in there, the charcoal, to help keep the water a little bit more clean and tidy. The pumice to help keep things aerated, but it's not like proper layers. Like I said, there's just not enough depth in there to do that with this one. And there is another planting pocket up top I almost forgot about. I put a little bit in there. That doesn't really look like very much though, does it? I should probably put a little more. Just a little. Doesn't need very much. And I'm not going to be overcrowding this with plants either. There's just a few I'm going to start with. This is one of the types of things where I kind of want to work on it as time goes on. So in this video, this is really just going to kind of be like my jumping off point with this one. And over time, I'll add to it, but I'll probably just be adding like rocks and sticks and things like that to it. I don't know how much heavier I'm going to go on plants than what I'm going to do right now. One thing I have found with this Coco Bop is that it really deflates once it's watered. So having a little bit extra in here is okay, but I do want to make sure to account for the fact that I'm going to have to displace soil to put plants in here too. Same thing goes with this little section up top. I can go a little bit more deep with that one because you can't see it from the front, so I don't have to worry about it being like overly exposed or whatever. I don't really know what I'm trying to say there. You can't see it from the front. That's what I was trying to say. So you can't really see it as much, and it's not going to be blocking that little pass through that was down there. That little hole that I was talking about that I want to be able to see through. Here's where things get tricky. It's not really tricky. I'm pretty sure it's going to be fairly simple, actually. I just have to go through and figure out how I'm going to get the soil into that slope without it basically all just washing down. But I'm thinking that I will be planting that slope fairly heavily, hopefully. So there should be like some sort of kind of erosion control. It's hard to say for some reason. The plant that I'm going to put up here that should keep the soil from just all washing down to the bottom. Yeah, I think that's laid out about how I'm going to want it. Again, you can see that layer down there, very minimal, but it's enough. It's plenty for what's going to be going in here. I had mentioned that I want there to be sort of an essence of water with this setup. So I picked up a few of these little pilea. This is Pilea glauca. You can see it has kind of a bluish hint to it, more of a silvery gray tone. That's where the term glauca, that's where that comes from. But that to me is that's going to represent water for me in this case. I'm thinking I'll just plant it so it goes down this slope here. I have a few others so I can fill in gaps if I need to. There's sort of an overhang right there, and I'm thinking that's where I want this to go. I want this to, the pilea that is, I want that to just sort of drape over that edge. Right, and with that pilea in place, thinking I might add another one right here just to continue it down, and then I'm going to put another one right down there in the bottom. Before I go too far with this, I was thinking it might look kind of cool to put some moss on that slope. Like if the moss was basically the entire slope and the pilea came over the top of it and grew over that over time, then it would have a contrast to it and maybe would have like the resemblance to a stream. I don't know. I'm putting like way too much thought into this, but I think that it would look nice to have some moss in there. Sometimes I just like to play around with them to make sure I like the idea before I go too far, but I like that. So the reason I have the split into two is because I'm going to put another piece of the pilea. And I think that that would look nice to just kind of have it repeating in there, more just for like instant gratification than anything. The stuff I planted up top will, without a doubt, do everything that needs to be done as far as growing down the slope goes, but I don't know. Like I said, instant gratification. More instant, I guess I should say. I'm gonna take some time for that to grow from the top all the way down, but it helps a little bit. And what? Oh, another one. Yeah, because this empties down into this little basin here. I want it to look like there's a pool, right? So should go ahead and drop another one in there. Okay, so I've somewhat kind of established my little like mountainy metaphoric stream there. Now I'm going to take a minute and figure out what else, if anything else, do I want to plant in here. Okay, so for one, camera died, so this is basically done. Sorry. I don't know what happened because I have it plugged in instead of on a battery. I don't know. But the other thing that happened was in the process of trying to get this thing cleaned up, one of the things I was worried about happened, which was that all of the water from up here in the sides came right down, pulled up in here in the very bottom. So I thought, hey, this would be a good time to talk about what to do if you overwater something that doesn't have any drainage in it. It also spurred me to have kind of some different ideas of what I might want to do with this, but I'll get to that in just a second. Now, if you are extremely easily offended, look away because this might bother you.
If it does, I think that that's stupid.
Hey, you know what? You do you. Never hurts to have one of these laying around in your first aid kit, right? You put them in your nose. You get a nosebleed. Or maybe you have female friends. Or maybe you are a female. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know your life. But look at how easy this is. And it works like magic. You just go ahead and stick one of these puppies down in the soil. And that'll take care of your problem right there.
Just give it a couple minutes to soak some things up. The water that is, and pull that out of there, and usually problem solved. Might need more than one. Maybe I don't know which kind I have, but I guess they're not like the super supers, because this one's not doing quite as much as the last time I had to do this. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe something more absorbent. This one didn't do the trick, but I think what I had was like a variety pack or something. Anyways, you get the point. Paper towels work also. But getting back on topic here, not putting tampons in my planter anymore, this all led me to an idea. You see there's still some water in there? That's okay. Because I was thinking that it might actually look kind of cool to not have anything down here and just let water sit in that basin. With some rocks, I think that might look kind of neat. I mean, this looks pretty, but I have that going on up top too. Doesn't want to focus. This glass has lots and lots of bubbles in it. And it's not behaving for the camera. But I think that might look kind of cool. Just have like a little lagoon here, throw some gravel in it, and I could add like some type of teeny tiny little aquatic plants to it over time if I ever stumble upon them. That might be, let's see how it looks. Right, so if I'm going to do this, I got that cleared out, as you can see here. I think it would be smart to have a layer of some sort of, like, some kind of barrier here with some of that carbon or charcoal in it, just that whenever this does get watered, it doesn't just fill this basin up with sludge. I mean, that'll settle in everything, but it just seems like, since I'm here right now, why not go ahead and do that, right?
Okay, I think that's about as clean as I'm going to be able to get that for the time being. I can always make adjustments as time goes on, because I am going to want that water to be clear, right? I'm not going to want that to be disgusting and gross like it is right now. That's just from all the stuff that's kind of washed down, the particulates, and I did rinse the rocks off beforehand, but I don't know, there's just a little bit of scum in the water. That's okay.
You have to make sure that that's not up too high, because then it will just wick all the way back up this entire thing and it'll be too moist. Now, since that goes up kind of high, levels right around here, and it should probably be more like right here. But this is an open top, and because of that, it should be okay, at least for right now. And then this rock that's in there, that's only in there to hold this rock in place, because this rock is the barrier that's holding back all of the carbon. I put a pretty heavy layer of carbon, or horticultural charcoal, in there. I gave it a good rinse first, but still, you can see it. There's a little bit of stuff in there. That's okay. It'll settle, and I can wick it back out with a paper towel or tampon.
Next time I'm at the pet shop, I'll probably get a little bag of a very natural-looking gravel or something to put down here, just so that it can kind of help hold this stone in place. And these are, like, literally, that's just sitting there to hold that one right in that spot.
As the moss grows and the pilea, well, more the pilea, that's going to actually put down roots. I'll have to stay on top of keeping it pruned, because it will just take over this entire thing. It's a pretty strong grower. So, but that's not a big deal. I think they'll be kind of fun keeping it pruned so that it maintains the flow coming down here and still has some openness so that the moss can still receive some light. But the moss, you know, they don't have roots, but the pilea does. And so as that establishes, it will create kind of a natural filter for when I do have to water this, then hopefully not so much scud and scum and whatnot will rinse down and collect in the bottom. But I mean, that's not too bad as it is. I don't mind that. Up top there is a cryptanthus right where the light wants to be. There you go. You can kind of see it a little bit better there. And then there is a neoregelia of some kind. I don't know what kind. It was just with a bunch of terrarium plants. I can't remember. It's from Josh's Frogs, and whatever it was, the description said it would stay under 6 inches, which is still going to be pretty big for this, but for right now, it's okay. I don't mind it. And then there's an unidentified fern that is just basically leaves. It's not much to show you, but as it grows, I'll keep you updated. And then as far as down here goes, once I have the stuff to really kind of sort that out and settle it, I do think I'll probably put in Anubias nana or maybe even some duckweed. That might look kind of cool. Just have a layer of duckweed floating on here with a couple of these neat rocks sticking out. I kind of like that idea.
I generally like to make sure that things are complete by the time I finish a video, but I don't really mind the idea of having something that's still going to require a little bit of work and finagling and playing around with. I'm okay with that, especially because it leaves things open. People always like to leave their suggestions down in the comments section, which I appreciate. And, you know, maybe we can come up with an idea together of something else to do here, but I'm pretty stuck on everything that's going on up there. Down here, I could play around with that a little bit, but I do, in person, it looks a lot cooler, I think. It's kind of hard to tell on this little screen. Actually, I really do like just that little pool of water. I think that looks neat. As time goes on, the pilea is not only going to be coming down here, but it will also come around and come down this slope as well. And because this has this gap in the back, I might put a tiny little puck LED in the back there to just sort of light it up a little bit at nighttime. I think that would look pretty cool. I don't know, just a thought. And like I said, this water will clear up over time. Some things will settle and it's not going to have that kind of grayish hint to it. It's never going to look crystal clear though, because this glass isn't crystal clear. That there's a lot of, what do they call it? Is it convoluted? I mean, that's not what convoluted means, but in glass, there's a word for all the bubbles. Whatever that word is. I highly doubt I'll be able to find it and insert it into the video. I'm sure somebody who's watching this knows and can put it down there in the comments section. And as this matures and more time goes by, I may put something over the top to help make it a little bit more of a closed system. I don't know. I'll just have to wait and see. The top isn't even. This is hand-blown glass. It has some imperfections. Oh, is that the word for all the bubbles? Imperfect. Whatever. But I could get one of those big, like, blown glass balls or something to set on top of there. And that would help seal it up a little bit better. But I just don't really think that's going to be necessary. And then especially with now having this little pond lagoon thing in here, that's going to make it probably way too humid if I close the top off. I don't know, though. Again, this is just kind of like a for fun experimenting thing. I wanted to just play around, get some stuff in here. It's really important to me to be able to keep things to scale. So this pilea has those teeny tiny little dainty leaves on it. The moss has a lot of texture. I didn't want to put anything in here that was too big and bold. I have some hemigraphis over here in the foreground here, and I had thought about maybe putting that up there. But I just think it would have thrown the balance off completely in here. I think that would have just been too much to have up here in the very top. I kind of like the idea of it just looking sort of like there was just a little stream or a spring somewhere that just kind of ended up in this bubble. That's ultimately what I wanted with this. I hadn't really planned. I had thought about maybe just doing water down here. Then after I had that pilea in there, I was like, you know, I think that that actually would look pretty cool. So there it is, right? Again, it's going to require some finessing. You know, there's some pieces of carbon still breaking through. I may need to actually probably go through and put a little piece of screen there. That will help hold things back a lot better. But since I'm just kind of winging it, and it's, you know, maybe it might be like 1 o'clock in the morning right now, I don't know, this has to do. It's okay for right now. Concept is in place. I'll keep expanding on it and playing with it as time goes on. Yeah, so there it is. There's my little attempt at kind of a little like mountainside stream terrarium something. I don't even know what I would call this. Mountain spring bubble terrarium? Maybe? It looks cool. That's all I care about. That cryptanthus I know is very bold up there and bright and not wanting to be on camera. There was going to be a pop of color in here. I wanted it to be up high in that little shelf up there because that would help pull the eye back and then it would create a depth. And having depth is really important for scale. So having that back there, again, you see it, and then it just kind of highlights in its own way everything that's in front of it and going on in there. Even though it's not a lot, it's pretty simple and basic. I didn't go overboard with it because I didn't want to take away from the glass, from the way that it's melted around this driftwood and everything, and I wanted it to just have its own little appeal. And like I said, just like a little chunk of earth in there, which is essentially what a terrarium is. Right? I like it. With some time, the pilea is going to get more and more of that bluish glaucous color to it once I get this more into a spot where it's getting some bright light. It's going to be indirect light, but it'll be fairly bright. If I stumble upon some isopods or something, I could always throw them in there. But again, this isn't really a bioactive, but it still helps the whole process of everything growing and whatnot. Since this is just stale, stagnant water down here, it is important to have that carbon layer, that charcoal,
So I will, like I mentioned before, probably put a little bit of sand or gravel or something with a layer of that carbon underneath it to help keep things a little bit more fresh. And ideally, I'll incorporate some sort of aquatic plant that can grow as a marginal, meaning that it would grow where the water meets the land, but maybe just a little bit below. There are actually a pretty good amount of plants out there that are sold at the pet stores, usually the ones that are in the tubes, that can be used for planting underwater or right at water level. Plants that tend to tolerate just fine living someplace where the water levels go up and down a lot. So there are a decent amount of options. Like I said, though, I think just like a layer of duckweed or something might look kind of cool. Just having that float around on the top and be able to see its little roots down below. That might be kind of neat. I'm okay with that. I don't know where I'm going to get any duckweed, especially this time of year, but I guess it's a good thing that I don't have any. I had some in my fish tank years ago, and oh my gosh, that took forever to get rid of. It's not something I'm going to let cross-contaminate in any way. That's not going to be getting into my other systems, not at all. I like it. Got the water, it's got the earth, has that little balance to it. Something about it just calms me, and that's what I wanted. But as always, comment down below. Tips, tricks, suggestions are always appreciated. And just say hi. It's fun talking to everybody. All of my social media is linked down below. I use Instagram way, 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 way more than anything else. The best place to get a hold of me. And, you know, if you don't mind, you could like the video. It makes a big difference for the channel. I really do appreciate it. And subscribe as well and hit that notification bell. That way you'll know when new videos come out. And you know, with the Terrarium Tuesday thing, there's only a few more of them left. And once I get to the end, I'll be going through and giving an update on all the terrariums that were made over the last several weeks. Whatever suggestions get made, if it fits and I like it, then I'll do it. And then we'll be able to see that in the final video. Okay, I'm gonna go now. Lots of other things to do. Hope everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye bye.